Welcome back to Soapncrafts. In my last video, I demonstrated two transparent soap recipes. One was made using fractionated coconut oil, and the other used regular solid coconut oil. The batch made with fractionated coconut oil didn't turn out as well as I expected. I'll be remaking that recipe again, using a newly purchased fractionated coconut oil. This is my original recipe. During the demonstration, I'll be cutting the recipe in half and making a small test batch. Just a reminder, this is a hot process soap-making method, and we will be working with lye. Please wear proper safety gear at all times, including gloves, mask, and eye protection, and make sure you are working in a well-ventilated area. Proceed at your own risk, and always follow standard soap-making safety practices. In a large measuring cup, weigh fractionated coconut oil and stearic acid. Heat the oil phase until the stearic acid is completely melted. Meanwhile, weigh the glycerin. This time, I'm using a different procedure and adding the glycerin at the end instead of adding it to the oil phase. And prepare the lye solution in a separate cup. Once both the lye solution and the oil mixture have reached the desired temperature, you can combine them. Without the addition of glycerin, the saponification reaction happens very quickly. Because of the high temperature, you can see the soap starting to rise and form a soap volcano. To prevent the rising soap volcano from spilling over, simply remove the pot from the heat. Keep stirring to help release heat and cool the mixture down. Once the soap is cooled down, pour in the glycerin. Continue heating the mixture over medium heat. Then slowly pour in the alcohol and stir gently. Pour in the remaining alcohol. Continue cooking over medium heat until the mixture becomes completely clear. For this process, we warmed the oil phase over 95 degrees Celsius and lye phase over 80 degrees Celsius. Alcohol and glycerin were off heat and were added later after soap mixed. After we pour in the alcohol and glycerin, the temperature dropped down below 60 degrees Celsius. Therefore, we have to add heat to it until the temperature reaches over 70 degrees Celsius. Whether you add the glycerin before mixing with the lye or after the lye has been added, the final result will be no much different, as long as the soap is well mixed and reaches hot process temperature. The only difference is that adding glycerin at the beginning can slow down the saponification reaction, which helps prevent a large soap volcano. Overall, the timing of when you add glycerin is flexible and does not affect the final transparency of the soap. If the mixture doesn't reach the required temperature during mixing, you can simply apply heat at the end. In most cases, this can be corrected and brought back on track. Comparing two batches of the same transparent soap using the exact same recipe, you can see how different quality fractionated coconut oil affects the soap's clarity and color. Hot process transparent soap usually takes 1 to 2 weeks to cure, but you can use it as a melt and pour base as soon as it has solidified. This batch was unmolded and cut after 3 days. Normally, I would wait longer so the soap is fully cured. This makes it harder and ensures that most of the alcohol has evaporated, so it won't have a strong smell. This year, while remaking this video, I tried a new approach to see if I could further optimize my transparent soap recipe and push the clarity to the maximum. And I did it. The bar on the right was made with fractionated coconut oil, and the one on the left was made with regular solid coconut oil. Both turned out extremely clear. I am sharing the updated recipe with you now. For the ultra-clear recipe, the coconut oil amount stays the same. Stearic acid helps with hardness, but it reduces clarity, so I lowered it to 45 grams. Glycerin and alcohol both improve transparency, so I increased both amounts. This gives much better clarity, but the soap will be softer. That's the trade-off for maximum transparency. Same procedure. After you've prepared and weighed all the ingredients, heat the oil mixture and the lye solution. Once lye solution and oil phase reach the desired temperature, you can then mix them. Add the alcohol in small amounts, pouring it in gradually in separate additions. Once the solution turns clear, continue heating it gently until all the white particles are completely dissolved. Turn off the heat and allow it to cool down before pouring to the mold. This batch took almost one full week to set. During the first 2 days, it was still completely liquid, and I honestly thought this recipe had failed. On the third day, it turned into a gel-like solid. After about 1 week, I was finally able to remove it from the mold. The surface was still slightly moist, but at least the soap had fully solidified. As the remaining water evaporated, the soap became even clearer and gradually hardened. I was very amazed by this result. I'm not sure if this will work the same way in a very humid environment, as humidity can significantly affect the curing process. These were the four batches we did in the two videos. You could see the difference. Thank you so much for watching. I've included hints and FAQs in the description below, so please make sure to go through them carefully. I'll also be sharing an updated non-alcohol transparent soap formula next in the member area. If you'd like to learn more and support my work, feel free to join the membership. Thanks again for your support.